In this video, I am going to explain about capacity to contract. To enter into a contract, an individual must have mental capacity sufficient to understand the nature and consequences of actions. Capacity to contract means the legal competence of a person to enter into a valid contract and the competence to perform some act. What are the legal requirements for a person entering into a contract? Section 10 of the Indian Contract Act enumerates certain conditions which must be fulfilled in order to constitute a valid contract. Section 10 also requires that the parties must be competent to contract. Section 11 of the Indian Contract Act 1872 defines the capacity to contract of a person. Section 12 lays down a test of soundness of mind. A contract is basically an agreement that is enforceable by law. In order to be enforceable, the agreement must satisfy the requirements given under Section 10 of the Indian Contract Act 1872. According to Section 10, an agreement becomes a contract if it is entered between the parties who are competent to contract. Section 11 of the Indian Contract Act 1872 defines the capacity of a person to be dependent on three aspects: attaining the age of majority, being of sound mind, and not disqualified from entering into a contract by any law that he is subject to. In this video, we will look at all aspects in a detailed manner. What is a sound mind for the purpose of contracting? A person is said to be of sound mind for the purpose of making a contract if, at the time when he makes it, he is capable of understanding it and of forming a rational judgment as to its effect upon his interest. A person who is usually of unsound mind but occasionally of sound mind may make a contract when he is of sound mind. There are a few reasons a person would not have the capacity to enter into a contract. Minors, the mentally ill, and persons who are intoxicated or drug addicted are generally excluded from entering into legal agreements. An individual who has been declared incompetent in a court proceeding lacks the legal capacity to enter into a contract with another. Minor, since any person less than 18 years of age does not have the capacity to contract, any agreement made with a minor is void ab initio. Idiot. An idiot is a person who has completely lost his mental powers. He does not exhibit understanding of even ordinary matters. Idiocy is permanent. An agreement with an idiot, like that of minors, is void. Lunatic is a person who is mentally deranged due to some mental strain or personal experience. He suffers from intermittent intervals of sanity and insanity. He can enter contracts during the period when he is of sound mind. Drunken or intoxicated persons. The law puts a drunk person on the same pedestal as that of an incompetent person, since it is presumed that the drunk party may have been incapable of understanding what he or she is agreeing to. A contract made by a person while he is so drunk as to be incapable of understanding its nature and effect is voidable at his option. So, certain types of people are specifically disqualified by special statutes from entering into valid contracts. Alien enemies. A person who is not an Indian citizen is an alien. On the declaration of war between India and alien's country, the country becomes an alien enemy. A contract with an enemy becomes unenforceable on the outbreak of war. With regard to a contract with an alien enemy, following rules will apply. Since trading with an alien enemy is considered illegal, no contract can be made with an alien enemy during the subsistence of war except with the prior approval from the central government. Contracts entered into before the outbreak of war will be suspended during the course of war. They will be performed after the war is over. Convicts. While undergoing sentence, a convict is incapable of entering into a contract. This inability comes to an end on the expiration of the sentence or if he has been pardoned. Corporations. A corporation is only an artificial person created by law. Example, a company registered under the Companies Act. Public bodies created by statute, such as Industrial Finance Corporation of India, a corporation exists only in contemplation of law. It has no physical body or form. It can hold property, can sell or purchase goods, and can hew or be hewed in relation to any of the contracts entered into by it. Being a mere creature of law, it cannot go beyond those objectives which have been laid down in the charter of its creation, that is, Memorandum of Association. Further, its capacity and powers to contract are also limited by its charter. Any contract beyond such power is ultra vires and void.
Thank you for the patient listening.